Hello students, in continuation of our topic partitions, I am going to discuss our next theorem that has three parts. For any m and n, this is the statement p m n is equal to p n. If n is less than equal to m, p m n is less than equal to p n, and this thing. Firstly, I will prove part 2. We have already observed this thing. Pmn is number of partitions of n into parts that are not larger than m. That is, obviously these are the restricted partitions. This is definitely less than total number of all partitions, that is less than equal to pn. So this is very obvious thing by the definition. Next thing, on part 1, I'll divide the partitions into two sets. S be the set of all partitions of n, that means cardinality of S is pn, that is total number of all partitions of n, and T is that partitions into parts less than equal to m, that means in that case norm T, mod of T is pmn. By part 1 we have already done that mod T is less than equal to mod s. These are restricted partitions, these are all partitions. Mod t is always less than equal to mod s, whatever will be the value of m or n. Now for the reverse inequality, if pi n be any partition of n, that means pi n is a member of s, pi n is any partition of n, then pi n is of the form a1 plus a2 plus ar, where each ai is greater than 0. Ai's are all summands of the partition pi n. Each summand value is less than equal to n, and n is again less than equal to m. That means this is sum of numbers a1 plus a2 plus ar whose sum is equal to n, and each ai is less than equal to m. Each ai is less than equal to m. That means a1 plus a2 plus ar, that is equal to n. That means this thing is a partition of n into parts less than equal to m. That means pi n is a partition of n into parts less than equal to m. That means pi n is an element of the set T. T was the set of all partitions of n into parts less than equal to m. That means we had considered any partition of n, an element of S that is contained in T. That means mod S is less than equal to mod T. From these two things, we get that mod S is equal to T. Now the basic thing is S is contained in T. We have done this thing only in the case when n is less than equal to m. Otherwise, it is not possible. Otherwise, the only this inequality holds, that mod T is less than equal to mod S. Third part. Pmn is Pm minus 1 into n plus Pm n minus m. If n is greater than equal to m, greater than 1. We'll prove this by showing that any partition of this form, any partition which is counted here, is either counted here or counted here. So by fundamental principle of addition, any element of this set is either here or here. That means the number of elements in this set is equal to number of elements in this set plus number of elements in this set. This is the basic funda. So what we'll take, we'll again consider pi be any partition of n into parts, pi be a partition which is counted here. Counted here means it is a partition of n into parts, each part less than equal to m, each ai is less than equal to m. Now there are two cases, either all the parts are strictly less than m, or one part or two parts may be equal to m. If all parts are less than m, then n is a part, then this is a partition of n into parts, each part less than m means less than equal to m minus 1. That means we have got a partition of n into parts, each part less than equal to m minus 1. That means this is a partition which is being counted in pm minus 1 n. Number of partitions of n into parts, each part less than equal to m minus 1. This is the first set. Now, other case can be m can be a part or m cannot be a part. M is not a part, we have already discussed. When m is a part, then since m is the largest value, I can assume that a1 is equal to m. N can be written as m plus something something. Now, this thing is equal to n minus m, where each ai is less than equal to m, because we have not said that partitions are with the distinct parts. Maybe a partition can have m as a part two times. So it can be m plus something something something. So it these things, these numbers will be, we are very sure that these are less than equal to m, and its sum will be equal to n minus m. A2 plus ar is a partition of what? N minus m into parts, each ai less than equal to m. Corresponding to each such partition of n with m as a part, we have got a partition of n minus m into parts, each less than equal to m. That means the number of partitions of this type is equal to the number of partitions of n minus m with each part less than equal to m. That means any partition is of either this type or of this type. Each partition of n can be of type 1 or of type 2. That means total number of partitions will be equal to either that partition will be counted here or counted here. That means sum of all these two numbers is equal to this number. Now, I want to elaborate it with an example. Suppose I take n is equal to 6 and m is equal to 2. Then these are the partitions with part less than equal to 2. This is a partition which does not has 2 as a part. M is equal to 2, which does not has 2 as a part. That is, it is a partition of the form type 1. Each part size is less than equal to m minus 1. Or when you have these partitions, where m is a part, 2 is a part, then remaining thing, this is 2, this is 2, 2 is a part, 2 is a part. Remaining thing is a partition of 4, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, partition of 4, partition of 4. But these are not all partitions of 4, but those partitions of 4 with part less than equal to 2. Partition of n minus m, partition of 6 minus 2 into parts less than equal to 2. Similarly, if I take m is equal to 3, either 3 is a part or 3 is not a part. 3 is not a part means partition of 6 into parts less than equal to 3 minus 1, less than equal to 2. And if 3 is a part, rest thing is a partition of n minus m, 6 minus 3, 3, partition of 3 with part size less than equal to 2. Next thing, I'm going to discuss is Farrer's graph. If you have a partition 6 is equal to 2 plus 1 plus 1, Farrer graph of this partition is, make 2 crosses over here, 2, then 2, then 1, then 1. you can use dots over here.